John Barry joining me here on the Rich Eisen Show. What the hell happened to the Cavs on Sunday, John? What happened?
Well, LeBron didn't happen. That was a major issue. I mean, he went for 11 points. He didn't score in the fourth quarter. He had six turnovers. And I get a great seat. I sit right next to the Cleveland bench, and I thought he was fatigued. He came over four or five times to Tyronn Lue and said he needed a break. Something was up. He wasn't out in the warm-up line during the national anthem. I don't know what that meant. That's a rarity, though. He had opportunities with Kelly Olynyk guarding him, Al Horford from the top. He couldn't get to the rim. He didn't have any lift. There were guys jumping over him for rebounds from Boston. Physically, it was not the LeBron James that we've seen over the past couple months.
Man.
And I don't know what it was, but hey, he's human.
Yeah,
cut him open. The blood was red.
Yes, right.
And he had a bad game, and that's it. So let's leave it be. I guarantee you tonight he bounces back, and I think he'll be somewhat of a factor in this game.
Okay. And if he doesn't, then we'll start wondering what gives. Certainly,
yeah.
You know, with the amount of rest in between series, and then obviously the one out of every 10 games being missed during the regular season, that he shouldn't be fatigued, right?
I agree.
I mean, that shouldn't be happening.
You know, it's just, someday your body just doesn't maybe do it. You know, that can happen. I mean, he played 42 minutes a night. So maybe it's just one of those days. Maybe, you know, didn't sleep well or who knows. But if he has another night like that, then I'm going to do some real digging and I'll let you know.
Okay. In the meantime, though, we could hot take it. You know, and say that he'll never be as good as Jordan. He'll never even be in the same breath as Jordan because Jordan never had a clunker like that. And blah blah blah. I mean, certainly,
well, right, Rich. That's what people go back to, right? When we get into the Jordan talk, you say these are the type of games that LeBron has. And look, he hasn't really had one since about 2011 like this in the playoffs. But that's what people will talk about. Michael Jordan never did this. I think Michael's lowest playoff game ever was 15 points. That was the lowest scoring game he ever had in the playoffs. And he never scored under 20 in an NBA Finals game. Always 20-plus. So, you know, take it for what it's worth. But, look, it's one bad game. Again, I think he bounces back. And I think Cleveland bounces back in a big way tonight as well.
The Rich Eisen Show. Weekdays at noon Eastern on radio stations across the country and audience.
If you like that, download our app. Please, just if it's a memory thing, just delete other apps. You don't need those apps. This app, the Rich Eisen Show app, you need that.